6 mind-blowing facts about Viking parties. So the Vikings are surely not new to the audience, because modern television and shows have surely added to their popularity. But what also has to be stated is how much of a great party animal the Vikings were, since they held the best parties of their time. It may be difficult to distinguish between myths and legends that were true and those that are not, since there are so many of them. But for you today, we have brought 6 amazing facts about how insane the Viking parties were, so keep watching to know more. But before we jump into the video, do not forget to subscribe to Historical Saga to not miss out on our best content. The Vikings are popularly known and have a place among the legends as great traders, explorers, and warriors. However, they weren't playing around as they descended. The Norse sagas describe heroic journeys, and much historical research has shed light on the places they visited and established. Archaeological evidence has uncovered records of the armor and weapons they used in battle. But what our contemporary understanding of the Vikings frequently ignores, sadly, is the fact that in addition to exciting excursions to distant regions, the Vikings also had some rather wild celebrations. This video will tell you all about what Viking parties were like. 6. The Viking Festivals. The Viking banquets are known worldwide to be some of the biggest social gatherings in human history. What were they about? Surely a lot of delicious food, the occasional sacrifice, and days of living entertainment, party activities, and incredible feats of bravery. Sagas from Iceland were used to record a large portion of what we know about the Vikings. The issue is that many of these tales were recorded hundreds of years after their occurrence, if at all they happened. Vikings held celebrations as a method to pay their respect for the gods and enigmatic powers they believed ruled the world. It also entailed performing sacrificial rituals. With the shifting of the seasons, there were surely at least 4 fixed blot sacrifices each year. A blot was a sacrifice made as a trade-off. The gods receive a slain animal, and the Vikings received favorable conditions or good fortune in combat. Many of these rites were performed as so-called blot sacrifices. In these direct interactions with the divine, the Vikings would sacrifice an animal or creature to the gods in exchange for something specific, such as favorable weather or success in an upcoming war. When their gods were called upon by the Vikings for a specific reason, such as a request for increased crop growth, additional sacrifices were made. What about a harvest celebration? It meant that it was time to start bleeding. Numerous animals, including horses, goats, and birds, were sacrificed. According to some tales, if they thought it would help them gain favor with the gods, Vikings may have even sacrificed the occasional human. Yikes. 5. The magnificent venues. When parties are held in specific structures, you know they are important events. In their mead halls, the Vikings did just that. These immensely huge structures, which were frequently on the estate of a strong lord, were large enough to accommodate magnificent celebrations. Some halls found during archaeological excavations were as long as 50 meters, or about half the length of a football field. A building that was discovered had 4 entrances and a width of 14 meters, which was about 46 feet. The structure resembled those Beowulf described. Apathetic attempts to celebrate all night long would have been mocked by the Vikings, because even their smallest feasts lasted for days. These were usually hosted following an adventure or wedding. It's possible that celebrations for important occasions like the winter solstice extended for 12 days. Yule, a protracted winter festival, served as the inspiration for many of the Christmas customs we follow today. 4. Not a Viking party without its drinks. The Vikings realized that a gathering is not a party without drinks. They served visitors a range of roasted meats and packed feasts with food and wine that was considerably superior to a daily meal. They offered greens, fruits, and veggies with butter on side dishes. The Vikings also advocated heavy drinking. They would toast frequently during their frequent drinking sessions, some to the Sir, their gods, and others to kings or men who had done honorable things. In other words, they spent weeks at a time camped out in enormous huts and overindulged in meat, alcohol, and vegetables that they didn't need to leave. A mini Coachella week, so to speak. 3. Live music for the party lovers. Vikings also loved live music, much like us. Flute, hornpipe, and other stringed instruments have all been discovered by archaeologists in their towns. Arab travelers who may have traveled to Viking-era countries claim that their songs were hard to hear since they were sung while intoxicated. This makes sense if you are familiar with Scandinavian metal. They would also listen to poetry read to them by skalds. Numerous of these poems describe the heroic deeds and extensive history of the Viking people, which is somewhat like Scandinavian metal. 2. The party games. But along with music, the Vikings kept their parties lively with the party games. Without party games, how can your party be considered complete? The Vikings used to pass the time indoors by playing early versions of chess or rolling dice. Additionally, they had their own set of strategic games, such as Hnefatafl. The popular flighting drinking game, which involved teams of men and women taking turns reciting poetry, is described in Viking sagas. They would also occasionally take part in pure drinking competitions to see who could stay sober the longest. Quite the classic. However, many Viking party games featured a built-in element of danger. It is said that partygoers intentionally hurt one another by hurling leftover bones at one another. In a swimming competition, competitors had to keep their rival submerged for the longest time possible. Other Viking competitions were so physically demanding that competitors frequently ended up with severe physical harm or could even end up dying. Axes being rammed into unaware heads and broken bones are common descriptions of team ball games turning into deadly feuds. 1. Parties as a sign of status. Tell me, why do we throw the occasional parties nowadays? Occasional holidays or birthdays? Similar motives led the Vikings to host gatherings and parties. Some were used to ring in the new year or for pagan rituals during the changing of the seasons. Other occasions included weddings and successful raiding expeditions to commemorate good fortune. Influential Vikings often utilized feasts as a political show of strength and status. However, the Norse saved their most lavish feasts to honor their gods and maintain their favor. Viking celebrations were, however, not intimate family affairs. Norse towns contained several hundred inhabitants and celebrations frequently included the whole neighborhood. Leaders used parties as an opportunity to flaunt their importance, wealth, influence, and status. Vikings brought out their largest benches and tables to seat hundreds of people. According to scholars, chairs were a rare item and only powerful Vikings possessed them. Numerous inebriated Vikings are now seated uncomfortably on benches. It makes sense why they were murdering one another during party games. The majority of Viking clothing was straightforward, robust, and made to keep out the cold. However, parties and events provided Vikings with an excuse to dress in their most expensive materials and jewelry. Men donned gold belt buckles and women sported international brooches, necklaces, and other jewelry. According to literary sources, fancy attire included form-fitting garments and beads made of glass or minerals. To bring attention to their breasts, women may have worn metal plates over them. Expensive clothing was brightly colored and colored using plant ingredients. Most of the clothing worn by common Vikings was made of wool, linen, or fleece. Only the richest Vikings could afford to import silk from distant regions. And that's it on the history of how the Vikings managed to win the title of the greatest party animals to have ever existed. If you found this video to be fascinating, do let us know in the comment section down below. Also, do not forget to like and share this video and subscribe to our channel. Check out our playlist and stay tuned for the best and most fun historical content. We will see you soon.